It is a time-honored tradition.
There's the opening bell on the S&P 500.
The ringing of the opening and closing bells at the New York Stock Exchange.
100 million people watch the opening and closing bells each day.
Markforged, the leader in continuous carbon fiber 3D printing, are preparing to go public.
We thought that we wanted to go big.
The plan is to 3D print our own version of the bell in metal. So when we go public, we're actually going to be bringing our own bell built with our technology.
We have the ability to print things out of metal and continuous composites. These are structural components. So printing our own bell that we can ring on the day of the IPO is the most Markforged way to go public.
The Markforged team has entered the trading floor and everyone is waiting to get a look at what these engineers have created.
Hey, it's Ross here from Markforged. We are in the heart of New York, here to reverse engineer the ticker bell.
My role in 3D printing the bell is to execute on the design. The first step was flying down to the New York Stock Exchange, walking up to the bell, and then create a one-for-one replica. The original bell, it's iconic. It's quite an elegant design, and it's been sitting inside that exchange for years. Not only are we going to ring this bell at the moment we become a publicly traded company, but it is going to be living inside the New York Stock Exchange for the rest of history. Let's hope I don't screw up.
When people think about 3D printing, they usually think about these, you know, desktop plastic printers that they're using to print, you know, Yoda heads or little desktop tchotchkes. But Markforged, what we actually have built is, I mean, you could print a Yoda head, it would just be out of stainless steel.
This is a part that's made out of steel and started out on these printers. Literally, it comes off the printer and a day later we have like a sintered and ready metal part, which is kind of unheard of in terms of turnaround time.
We invented a box that you can put your idea into, and out the other side comes a part that you can actually use. Made out of carbon fiber, or stainless steel, or copper, or Inconel, or Kevlar, that you can then take and put onto your robot, or onto your factory floor, or into your product, and then ship it.
Markforged is involved in anything and everything. The automotive industry, all the way to the aerospace industry, to biomedical, to mom and pop machine shops that are making bolts or anything. You know, if someone's making something, there's room for a 3D printer. And if there's room for a 3D printer, there's room for a Markforged system.
So I just wanted to show you a bit of an idea.
I don't even know if I feel good without a raft on this either, but we can make the raft smaller, like without even any offset. We came up with a small team to streamline the design process.
I mean, we probably get two, maybe three cracks at this. And then if we...
I'm a little worried about it. Because I want whatever we do to be visually stunning.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. I am a little nervous though, like as far as risk goes.
As we were going through the design process, it dawned on us that we shouldn't just copy it. We should do something that really captivates the Markforged technology and is something that only our technology can actually physically produce.
We're leveraging all our technology to make this bell happen and really showcase what our printers can do. You know, we wanted something that could highlight our capabilities as well as our ability to design and think.
So we came up with this new design. This design isn't like any bell that you've seen before. It's split up into six different components, which is a nod to our logo, which consists of a six-sided hexagon. The bell itself is going to be made out of a full suite of materials that Markforged uses every day. 17-4 stainless steel, a copper button head cap with our logo front and center, with an Onyx base, reinforced with carbon fiber to ensure it is strong enough to stay up for the rest of history. I mean, we need to get this design perfect because it's going to live there forever.
You know, the date's coming up soon and the pressure is on, but we work with tight deadlines around here. That's what Markforged really does. We push the limit on technology and on getting things out the door fast.
we have finally hit the point where the bell is printing, and now it's up to the printer to do the rest.
It's got roughly 1,500 layers to print. We're looking at a very tight deadline. We have some more work to do. Everything's gonna be fine. It'll be fine.
So if we were to machine this bell out of a massive billet of steel, first we would have to wait weeks, if not months, just to get that massive piece of steel. From there, we would have to get the special cutting tools to remove the material and arrive at the final shape. And if any issues occurred during this stage of the process, we would have to scrap the entire thing and start over.
Hey, it's Ross here from Markforged. You're looking at this beautiful trophy right here. We got six more bell sections to go. We are really pushing it to the tail end. Like, we're really kind of close. We're gonna make it. Don't worry. We're gonna make it.
Markforged CTO David Benheim ready to ring in the company.
Everything around us is manufactured. Your iPhone, your car, your pants, your house, your furniture, and then the pieces of equipment that make all of those things, all of that stuff is made. But the limits of what we can create are fundamentally bound by our technology that produces those pieces. You know, plus the constraints of cost, we are limited by traditional manufacturing, what we can imagine. But we believe in a world where those limits don't exist. Where human imagination can manifest easily in front of you. We are reinventing the fundamental building blocks of manufacturing so that anything you imagine can be built today.